appreciate with all the players. It'll be that they're time for, you know, no money, no costs.
I do understand, sir, but Travel Expert often gets it wrong. The reviews on there about our Majestic Hotel are very misleading. At least the bad ones are. The good ones are extremely accurate, of course. But you still want to cancel? You sure I can't change your mind? Very well. I'll return your deposit as soon as possible. Thank you. Oh dear.
Oh, what's up, me dear? You sound a bit down.
Oh, I am, Mrs. Dyson. We've just had another cancellation. Curse that Travel Expert website. It gives totally the wrong idea about our lovely hotel.
The wrong impression? Lovely hotel? What shade of rose is the tint in your glasses, Miss Tremble? Just look around you.
Oh, I know, I know. The old place isn't what it was, but I remember what it used to be. Smart, stylish.
Well, that was a good few years ago. Nowadays, it's no surprise these negative reports are going on Travel Expert. Let's face it, the place is downright shabby. I do my best, but there's only me and I've got one pair of hands, not ten. It's about time Mrs. Borthright spent some money on this place instead of letting it go to rack and ruin.
That's part of the problem. With fewer and fewer people staying, there's less money to improve things. I'm getting really quite concerned.
I don't like to see my employees standing around gossiping. And you, Mrs. Dyson, should not be in front of all the guests. Now, please, put yourself away somewhere.
Yes, Mrs. Borthright.
I'm sorry to tell you, Mrs. Borthright, but there's been another cancellation. Party of four due to stay for a long weekend. They'd read the reviews on...
Don't tell me. Travel Expert. Was it the one about the frog in the bathroom? Or the one where Gaspar dropped the bacon rasher on the floor of the restaurant, wiped it on his apron and put it back on the guest's plate?
It was all of them.
Oh, dear God. I'm going to be bankrupt before the end of the season. If only I could get some good reviews to outweigh the bad ones. And to make matters worse, that damned website has started sending out secret hotel inspectors to check on the reports they receive. If we get a bad report from one of them, we're finished.
I wouldn't worry too much about that. It could be years before they get round to visiting the Majestic.
Oh, no, Mr. Simpson, I'll be back later this afternoon. Please put out three clean towels. That's three, not two. And for when I return, and put out some of those coffee sachet thingies. You never leave out enough.
Put on the other hand. However, I need to see Gaspar. Do you have any idea where he is?
Oh, I haven't seen him for a while.
That man is never around when I need him.
Excuse me. This is the Majestic, isn't it? Only there didn't seem to be a sign.
Sorry about that. It fell down in the recent storms and we sort of haven't got around to putting it back up yet.
No matter. The name's Colin Humphrey. I'm booked in for three nights.
Oh, Humphrey. Oh, yes, here you are. You're in room five. Yeah. Up the small flight of stairs and to your left. Sorry, we don't have anyone to carry your bag, but we're rather short-staffed at the moment.
That's fine, fine. I can manage perfectly well. Thank you. Really.
Oh, a tea is served in the lounge at four, if you're interested. Oh,
thank you very much.
Oh, let's just sit down for a minute. Oh. Well, that was a very... profitable shopping trip.
Indeed it was, Florence.
We should benefit very nicely.
Why, yes.
Ah, good afternoon, ladies. I don't suppose you've seen Gaspar anywhere?
No, we've just returned from the town. a little night shopping expedition.
Well, if you do happen to see him, please tell him I'm looking for him. Ah, Gaspar! I just need a little word.
That looks like trouble.
I'm particularly concerned about the huge drop in bar takings. Either we've suddenly become a mecca for teetotalers, or there's something funny going on.
Ah, may we, Madame Fortrata. Ah, hello, ladies. Have you had a good afternoon? Huh? Perhaps you took a promenade along the promenade? Huh?
Just a little constitutional, Gaspar. Well, we'd better go freshen up before tea. Oh, do excuse us.
Thank you. It's not just the bar takings. The menus haven't been up to much recently either.
Oh, but, madame, you know, how can I make a silk purse from Salzier, as they say?
Come off it, Gavin. Don't bother with the accent for my benefit. I already know your secret.
Yeah, and if you didn't, I wouldn't still be working for you at this tinpot hotel. No, I'd be at the Imperial or the Hilton, or maybe I'd have my own restaurant. Chez Gaspar! Instead of which, I'm still here working for a pittance.
At least I gave you a job. There weren't many people who would have employed you after the little incident at the hotel in Southport. No wonder you had to change your name and apparently your nationality.
Look, that epidemic was not my fault. It were a combination of unusual circumstances and ingredients.
You could always take a risk and walk away from here, you know.
Oh, yes, and lose my reputation as a chef when people find out that I'm Gavin from Grimsby instead of Gaspar de Paris. Not likely. Anyway, you know there's another reason why I stay.
Please don't start that again.
Look, you know I adore you. You're a strong, attractive woman. I mean, just leave this failing money pit and set up a business with me. I could make a success with you as my wife.
Gavin, Gaspar, it's not going to happen. I'm sorry.
I believe tea is going to be served.
Oh, yes, of course. I'll just check for you. It shouldn't be too long.
Hmm. 4 o'clock, they said for tea. 4 o'clock and it's 2 minutes past and no tea. I'm not impressed.
I'm not fussed to a couple of minutes. I'm sure he'll be here soon.
God, complete shambles, this place. You know, I found a hair in the basin. Oh, standards of cleanliness are not up to my usual standards, I must say.
Oh, good afternoon, gentlemen. Let me introduce myself. I am Florence, Lady Eubank, and this is Minnie Gentry, my companion.
Good afternoon. Colin Humphrey.
Oh, yes.
Turnbull.
Did I hear you commenting on the hotel as we arrived?
Only to say that I'm not impressed so far.
We have lived here since 1968. We are residents. We are very happy here.
You must have grown old and decrepit along with the rest of the building, eh, what? Still, even you will probably last longer than this rotten old place will. Hmm?
What a rude man.
Well, I'm not employed to make tea. And I'm not employed to serve it. I'm a receptionist, not a waitress. Where's Gaspar walked out anyway?
He just needed a breath of fresh air. He'll be back soon. Please.
No.
I'm sorry, ladies and gentlemen. We seem to be having a bit of a problem with the boiler. I'm afraid the tea is going to be considerably delayed. Might I suggest that, for once, you use the tea and coffee making facilities in your own rooms? Everything is complimentary, of course.
Ah! Typical! Oh, dear.
Was your trip successful? Did you get the stuff?
Yes, we did.
I thought at one stage we were going to get caught.
The store detective was looking at us so suspiciously.
Wheelchair. Oh, it's a boon for our little jaunts. You can hide everything under the blankets. Now, what have you ordered this time?
A bottle of vodka and a bottle of whiskey, please.
Whiskey?
Thank you. I think you might be able to do a bit of business with some of the new guests.
Oh, jolly good. We've certainly managed to run a lucrative little business so far. Now, that's £5 each, £10 in total.
A cheap drink for you,
and a profit for us. Bottles of the best tequila.
You're wicked, you know. You'll get caught one day.
Oh, I doubt it. Who would suspect you, sweet little old ladies?
Now, what shall I do with this bottle of pastis for Gaspar?
Oh, you hang on to it. We can give it to him later.
Right, dear. Can you manage?
Yes, I was just admiring the ceiling. This is quite an old building, isn't it? It's older than I first thought.
Oh, yes, it's a lovely place. I'm very fond of it. And I don't want to lose it. I'm sorry. I've just had a large glass of cooking sherry. I'm not quite myself.
My dear lady, Mrs.
Forthright,
isn't it? Stella, isn't it?
Yes.
Why do you think you could lose it?
Oh, we've had some dreadful reviews on that awful website, Travel Expert, and they may send an inspector at any time. I know things aren't perfect here, but they're not as bad as they make out, and the negative reviews affect the bookings, so I can't afford to do the repairs. Things don't pick up soon. I'm afraid I may have to go bankrupt.
That would be a shame. This hotel has a lot to offer. A lick of paint and a few more staff would make the world of difference.
I'm glad somebody else can see that. I'm very fond of the place. I love it.
Well, I'm sure things will buck up soon. And now I'm going to make a cup of tea by myself in my bedroom. Excuse me.
So that's what you're up to.
I'm sorry.
Chatting up the guests, making them feel at home, throwing yourself on the mercy.
Oh, Gavin, you're just being silly.
Silly, am I? Well, you know, sometimes silly people can do silly things. Anyway, I will go and prepare the menu for the dinner. And the sharpen the steak and knives.
Sorry to trouble you, but you're needed rather urgently in reception. What's going on? I think you best come out, Mrs. Forthright.
Oh, very well.
Gentlemen, that dinner at the Majestic is served between 7 and 8.30pm.
And I explained that I always take dinner at 6.30 on account of my delicate stomach. Oh, if I eat any later, I'm up all night racked with indigestion, and that makes me very grumpy.
I'm afraid my staff don't come in early enough to cook for you at 6.30. Perhaps we could agree a compromise. How does 6.45 sound?
Well, I suppose it might do. But make sure you're on time, for once.
What a
horrible man. But why did you agree to give him his dinner early?
To be fair, Mrs. Forthright, it's not like you.
I've been thinking, what if he actually is the hotel inspector? Surely he wouldn't make himself so obvious.
And obnoxious.
Yes, but that might be part of the plan. You know how supermarkets have mystery shoppers who go into the stores to see how the staff work with customers? Sometimes they're told to be as difficult as possible, getting into arguments, holding up the queues, that sort of thing, just to see how the staff react. Perhaps that's what Mr. Turnbull is doing.
Yes. I bet his name isn't even Turnbull.
So, we must all smile sweetly and do everything we can to please him. Then he might write a good recommendation for the Majestic. Because if things don't improve, I might even have to make some of this staff redundant. Or perhaps combine two jobs into one. I don't want that, but it might be necessary. I must push my personal feelings aside in order to keep the Majestic open. No room for sentiment. Now, I'll go and organise dinner.
Does that mean us? I need this job. I can't feed my kids without it. I'm struggling enough as it is. I would definitely won't cope on half a job's wages.
As you know, I don't have a family, but I do have my responsibilities towards Mummy, and her nursing home fees are so expensive. And apart from that, what exactly is she suggesting when she might combine two jobs into one? I don't want to sound patronising, but I can hardly do a proper job in reception if half the time I'm slumming it, wearing an overall and carrying a mop and bucket.
I'm not going to fall out with you, as we're both upset. Anyway, I wouldn't want to be a receptionist as well as a cleaner. You're good at being polite to people. I just tell them to get stuffed if they didn't like it the way it is.
But what's the alternative? We keep getting bad reviews and the Majestic has to close down, then we'll both be out of a job. Sometimes I hate that woman, I really do. And I hate Travel Expert even more.
You and me both, Lily. You and me both.
Good evening, Mrs. Forthright. Am I too soon for dinner?
Not at all, Mr. Humphrey. We're starting a little earlier this evening to accommodate one of the other guests. We always aim to please at the Majestic Hotel.
Well, I hope you've got things up and running for me. I like my meals fresh and hot, you know.
Yes, of course. I'll just go and check that Chef is ready, and then in a moment you can come through and peruse the menu.
I have to say, I think you're being rather hard on this place.
Well, it's not up to my normal standards, I can tell you.
I actually find it rather charming. It's a little bit the hotel that time forgot, but that adds to its period charm. Yes, I really rather like it. It's certainly a lot better than I've been led to believe.
Ladies and gentlemen, the dining room is now open. Oh. If you'd like to make your way through, and bon appetit.
I'm so sorry, everyone, but that's the fire alarm. I'm sure there's nothing serious going on, but we'll have to evacuate the building. The fire assembly point is on the far side of the car park. Please move there as quickly as possible.
It is not in the kitchen, I can assure you of that. Well, I'm not going anywhere. It's bound to be a false alarm. The electrics in this place are bound to be as decrepit as everything and everyone in it.
You're so silly, man. You could be burned to a crisp. As owner of this hotel, I'm responsible for you. And if I order you out, out you will go.
Well said, that woman.
Well, I'm only going as far as the foyer, and I can watch you idiots milling about.
Wonder if all hotel inspectors are as arrogant to ski is.
Obviously, this is fireproof.
Go, everyone. Go.
Oh,
See how proud he is. He even goes to sleep.
Do you know, he's been so awful. If he does write a poor review on the Majestic, I'm prepared to take him to court.
I think he's the worst guest we've ever had here.
I never left a hair in the basin, you know. It ain't that at all.
Come on, Mr. Turnbull. Time to go in to dinner. The crisis is over, as I'm sure you already know. Hey. The back of his head's caved in. He's dead.
Oh, what could have happened? An accident?
It doesn't look. Ita doesn't look like an accident. No, he looks as though he has been struck with a blunt instrument.
I suppose that's what you get for being a hotel inspector.
What do you mean?
Well, it was so vile to all of us and about the Majestic that it couldn't have been anything else.
But I'm the hotel inspector. We visit hotels quietly and anonymously. We certainly don't behave like he did. He was just a truly unpleasant person who probably got his kicks out of belittling others.
So he may have died for nothing?
And I was going to write up a first-class report upgrading the Majestic. I find it rather charming and somewhat refreshing.
So, will it affect our ratings now that one of our guests has been murdered?
She moved a few times before she settled on that one, and it had to be one that would take Winky Pooh, of course. Not many of them will take animals. She has a little Pekingese, you know, something that she's very, very fond of. Not what you need to know, is it?
Perhaps not, but I think you've answered the question.
Yes.
What was your job before you were a hotel receptionist?
Oh, I didn't work before, no. I shouldn't really have to work, you know. You know, Mummy's from a very good family, she really should have been titled, but Daddy never acknowledged her. I shouldn't have had to work at all, but for Mummy's nursing home fees getting a bit more than was left from the house sale, so I had to start working in order to. She's using her money to pay for the fees, but I need a bit of spending money for treats.
So is it tequila for you or your mum?
Oh, no, it's for me.
Two bottles a week, is it? Two bottles every week?
I find, you know, it just relaxes me, you know. Yeah. Just the odd drink or two. Anything else?
About three bottles of tequila.
Why would you comment about him having died in the...
Oh, yes, well, he wasn't the hotel inspector, was he? I mean, I'm presuming that's why somebody killed him, because, you know, I can't see it. Well, apart from the fact that he was not a fine, I suppose they might just have killed him
you know, I thought he was the hotel inspector, and I just thought that's why somebody thought they would put a stop to him putting in his report. Because it obviously wouldn't have been a good one for him, would it? Mind you, that's a nice man. But, so that's a shame, really, isn't it? Because he was going to put a good report in, wasn't he?
But you could have done it. You were going to lose, or perhaps have lost your job.
Oh, well, I couldn't kill anybody.
Any other questions for Lily? Then thank you very much, Lily.
Thank you.
Thanks for your time. Marjorie was the next person we met, so if you might swap seats, ladies.
How long have you been working at the hotel?
Well, be about 8 or 9 years, I'd say.
Do you like your job?
Well, it's all right. I mean, everybody has to clean a toilet every now and again, don't they? I just get a few more than everybody else. It's all right.
If you lost a job, would you have another job to fall back on?
Well, no one has to find one. I mean, they're not easy to come by these days.
Did you get enough GCSEs?
Well, you know, education's all right, isn't it? But in the real world, you need to be able to use your hands, don't you? To do something practical. That's what I thought.
How many children have you got?
Five.
Is it me?
Oh, aye. I love kids. Couldn't eat a whole one, like, but I do love
kids. Does your husband work?
No. That's the problem. He can't, you know. It's his bad back and his bad leg. Put the two together. It's not a good combination.
Is your husband the drinker, or are you the drinker?
Well, I mean... We like to enjoy ourselves, you know.
I know you've got five children.
Yeah.
So you both drink?
Oh, yes, definitely. Right. Yeah.
And how long will those two bottles last you? A week or
longer? Yeah, about a week, yeah.
So it's £10 every week, out of your wages?
Yeah. Well, I mean, if I was paying full price, blimey, I wouldn't be able to afford that.
You're only on minimum wage. £10 a week's a lot out of minimum wage.
Well, yeah, you've got to have your little pleasures, haven't you?
You've got five kids to look after as well.
Oh, yeah, well, they're all right. I mean, basically, once you've had the main one, the eldest one, you know, the others help to bring one another up. I mean, I don't do an awful lot these days.
No.
Any other questions for Marjorie?
Yes, have you got any idea? Do you think it's one of the staff that you've listed? Have you got any idea who it might be?
I can honestly say... I don't know who's done it. I mean, he was a horrible man, but, you know.
But if one of the staff was to kill him, it's not going to do the hotel much good. Unless somebody thinks they'll all flock there because a murder was committed in it.
Well, I suppose there's an upside to everything, really, isn't there? Yeah, I never thought of that. That's a good point. Good point. No, I didn't. That is a good point, that. Oh. Yeah. Might not do us any harm at all.
Last point about that.
How long have you been relying on the two Wicklow ladies to provide you a subsidised alcohol?
Oh, it's been a good few years now. I'm not sure how long have you been doing it now?
6 or 7 years.
There you go, 6 or 7 years. Time just goes, you know, it's a boon, really. I mean, to be honest with you, it's a public service that they're doing out there.
Thank you very much, Marjorie. Stella, I think you are the next to be introduced to us. Questions for Mrs. Fulbright?
How long have you owned the hotel?
I've been here 16 years now. I bought it after my husband sadly passed away. It's a little business venture. And I absolutely love it.
Can I stick?
He died in a diving accident in the Red Sea. He was the love of my life, but because of the insurance money, and I was able to come back to Blackpool. I was originally from Blackpool, and buy the little hotel. And
I thought I was going to ask, did you get good insurance money?
Well, it was enough to buy this place.
Yes.
Okay. Were you with him at the time?
I didn't dive. No. He'd gone off for the day on a little expedition.
Why don't you fancy the idea of a business going on?
I've known Gavin for many, many, many years, and you know, we get along fine, but he really isn't the sort of person I'd want to have a business with. He's very unpredictable, temperamental, you know, and I'm afraid that if we did go into business together, he might get the wrong idea and want it to be a bit more than a business relationship.
When you were outside, you as the owner of the hotel had to keep your eye on everybody that was out there, obviously, to make sure that they were all safe and not worried or anything. Did you notice anybody missing or sneaking off?
Well, we do actually have a procedure that we have to follow. When we have a fire drill, which we do every so often with the health and safety requirements as part of running a hotel, Lily, Miss Trumbull, is our fire officer, and she is the person that would actually take a roll call. I'm not sure I saw you doing that, Lily. Yes, she was in a lot of panic.
But it wasn't a drill, you see. We've not done it before like that, where we didn't know it was going to happen, so...
We thought it might have been a real fire.
Well, yes, quite, so, yes, I just don't know. I've had a bad day today.
Anyway, the only... I can't honestly say that I saw every single person, but I know for definite that Mr. Turnbull had refused to come out and was loitering around in the reception area.
Where did the fire alarm first spring from, so to speak?
Well,
what set it off?
I'm not sure. I haven't had a chance to investigate that yet, but we do have the break glass.
Yes.
There is one in reception, there's also one in the kitchen area, one in the hallway, and two or three on the different levels. So
how many of them have their glass broken?
I haven't had a chance to investigate that yet.
Any other questions?
Thank you, Mrs.
Then Mr. Humphrey, Olive, right at the hotel. Questions for Mr. Humphrey.
How long have you been a hotel inspector?
Oh, probably about 10 years now.
And which organisation do you work?
A travel expert, I'm sure you've heard of them. We're on the interweb and, you know, all that sort of thing. Yes.
So, because they had a nasty report from one of your...
Well, there have been a few nasty reports on the site, and of course, when we get a lot of nasty reports, they're not necessarily true. So we do make a point of investigating those particular hotels to see whether they are true, and then we can advise people who come onto our website that is the case. Or, as very often happens, they are not true, and it is important for our reputation that we get it right. And in this case, I have to say, I thought some of the adverse reports that were posted on our website were totally incorrect, and I shall make a point of putting that right. Yes.
You said that
say that you're a hotel inspector.
Mm.
Why should we believe that you're a hotel inspector? You've just said it.
Mm-hmm.
What proof have we got?
Oh, you want to see my paperwork,
yes,
do you? Well, I have got it upstairs in my room, and of course, had circumstances been different, I would have, you know, acknowledged the fact, but of course, you will appreciate that we are in the middle of a murder, and I had blood on my hands. I mean, what was I supposed to do? Suddenly create credentials and say, I'm the hotel inspector? No, I just said, I'm the hotel inspector, because I am.
That's quite...
Pardon?
I think it's quite irrelevant.
Oh, but I have. Yeah. I have. I can assure you, they are upstairs. And if you'd like to hang on for a few moments before the night is out, I shall present them to you and anybody else who wants to see it. Yes, yes, I am the hotel inspector. Yes.
Do you get paid more for a good report or a bad report?
It makes no difference. I am paid what I am paid. Obviously, you must appreciate if I was paid different rates of pay depending on what my report was, then that could be cause for, you know, insinuation that I'm bending the rules one way or the other. So obviously that does not happen.
Is this your first visit to the Majestic?
I'm sorry?
Is this your first visit?
Oh, absolutely. Absolutely,
Do you
yes.
know any of the members of staff here or any of the residents?
I'm sorry?
Do you know any of the members of staff or the residents?
Oh, not at all, no.
You've never met them before?
I haven't met any of them before, no, not at all. No.
Or the owner. Have you ever met the owner of Fylde?
The owner? Oh, well, Stella. Lovely lady. Lovely, charming. Charming. Things will improve, my dear, I promise you. No, I haven't. No.
Any further questions for...
Are you married?
Me?
Yes, but have you got a different hotelier in every town that you visit?
I'm embarrassed.
That's why you're going red.
Well, you're a sweet talking guy, as the song says. So are you like this with all the hoteliers you meet, female?
Good heavens, my dear woman. What sort of a person do you think I am? Well,
a philanderer.
I'm sorry. By the mere suggestion.
Are you answering the question or evading the question?
My dear lady, I can assure you that is not the case.
So this is a one-off?
What is a one-off?
This relationship that may develop between two of you.
Are you suggesting that because I'm being charming and polite and totally the opposite of the poor gentleman who has just deceased, there are reasons behind it?
Well, I would have thought as a professional, you would have had to be dispassionate and set yourself aside from whoever owned the hotel.
Well, I thought I was rather quiet and anonymous, as I claim that we all are as hotel yeah. inspectors.
Well, I thought you were sucking up to
Well, my dear, you can think what you like, but I can assure you that I am just as nice to everybody I meet, except, of course, that particular gentleman, Mr. Whatever he was called. Yes, but yeah. Yes.
I'm not satisfied with that. I'll let it pass for now.
Oh,
I may come back to you later.
You're very kind, my dear, you're very kind.
I think we'll leave it at that for the moment. Thank you, Mr. Holcrae.
You're very well.
Thank you. The two ladies we met at much the same time, but I think we will allow Lady Florence.
Are you all right?
Yes.
She's in kiss. He's still all right. There's a light in the
Right. Yes. Now, questions for Lady Florence. No, I'm
speaking to Catherine.
Sorry, I can't hear you.
When everyone's gathering for dinner,
you were there,
and with your walking stick, you indicated to your family not to follow the sort of point of the...
Oh, she always lags behind me. She's my companion, and she's supposed to be next to me and helping me, but she's always lagging behind.
That
Is that why you sort of get away with the stick?
Just to say, there. Come on.
How long have you been at the hotel?
Sorry?
How long and why did you first come to the hotel?
How long have we lived in the hotel?
Well, and more importantly, why?
Why? Because we're both in what we call estranged circumstances. I was married to a gentleman, that's why I'm lady. But he gambled all his money away and left me in pecuniary conditions. So I had to look for a hotel. And I knew Minnie from many, many, many years ago, and we had kept in touch. And I asked her if she would like to come as my companion.
How long have you been augmenting your income by going around and pilfering?
That's six or seven years.
Have you got a
criminal
record?
No, not yet. Not been caught. I suppose we'd be very lucky, really, but it's such an adventure.
Is your husband dead?
Sorry?
Your husband, is he dead?
But yes, he is now. He's dead. Yes, he is now. Pneumonia, I don't know. He went off with all the money and then I heard he died, so good riddance.
How long had you been married?
How long had I been married? Well, I was married when I was about 23. I've been in here since 1968, so you can tell. I don't know when he died. When would he die? After I came in here, because he'd gone somewhere else, so I suppose I should have been celebrating my 60th wedding anniversary, but it wasn't to be.
How did you know that the lady who does the housework and the receptionist, how did you know that they wanted your ill-gotten gains from studio?
Well, it started because Marjorie, who's a sweetie, said, "Oh, I love vodka." And one day I was... Minnie was pushing me in my wheelchair in this store. And you know how they have these lots of wines and things in rows? And as I went past this vodka, it was too tempting. So there was nobody about, so I just nipped one and put it under the blanket. Marjorie was delighted. So I thought, well, next time I'll see what else anybody wants. So that's how it started.
It seems to me that the higher cost spirits are usually higher up or even locked behind glass doors. If you're in a wheelchair, how are you reaching a higher shelf to get the dearest
spirits? Oh, we don't reach the higher shelves. We just get them from the bottom shelves. And if
but it's
I
the cheaper stuff.
That,
it's the cheaper stuff's at the bottom, usually.
Well, whatever. When we go along, if they've got a big display and there's nobody around, then we...
The lady that owns the hotel, because you've both lived in that hotel for a long time, that really is your home.
Yes.
So you really, really wouldn't mind the hotel inspector to write about the cost of that, would you?
We would.
Because you would lose your home.
Oh, yeah. Absolutely.
So aren't you quite close to the lady that owns your hotel?
No, not really. She didn't know about us. Your business at all. This all came out. I could see her having a look and come out now, isn't it?
There's a ledger on the front room.
Oh, sorry.
Does the income from your pilfering keep you at the hotel?
No, we have a little bit of money that pays for the hotel. It pays for extras that we buy bottles. It's only a fiver a bottle we get from there.
Right, thank you very much. We'll move on to Minnie. If you would like to do a swap, I'd like some assistance.
Yes, I'm fine. Are you
okay,
madam?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yes. Questions for Minnie Gentry?
Are you, Minnie? Are you the one that's reaching the dearer price spirits that you're pinching?
Yes, I go to the supermarket.
So you're the one that's reaching,
yes.
You're not low level, is your
No, it's...
Employer said.
It's usually on the third or... Well, it'll look her being down there. She won't realise, you know. So, usually on the third or fourth
So shelf. She was lying before when she said it was all down at the bottom of the shelves?
I don't know, really. But it's me, because she's in the chair. It's me that lifts it up.
So it is higher shelf items.
And she puts it under her blanket.
So.
What happened to your husband?
He went... He went over to the Isle of Man for the day to test the T2 course in his motorbike, and he crashed and was killed, I'm afraid.
And did he leave you in peculiar circumstances?
Well, I wasn't really well off, but all right, you know, just all right.
Do you go 50-50 on the profits from the alcohol?
We have a communal purse, shall we say, and we put it in there, and then when we want a little extra, you know, we might see a nice lipstick or something.
Don't go for that.
No, just, we had no course. I must ask the girls whether they want
the
lipsticks.
That's
an idea.
How much does the lady pay you for being a companion?
Well, she doesn't pay me anything. We've been friends. We first met at boarding school in the Lake District, as a matter of fact. She was a bit older than me, as you can see, and she looked out. we got on well and kept in touch, and so we each pay our way at the hotel.
She doesn't talk about you as an equal.
Sorry?
She doesn't speak of you as an equal.
Well, we are. I mean, she's a lady, but we've been friends, you know.
Well, we're all ladies, but...
But she is a lady, you bet.
Well, she's just a woman the same as you.
Yes,
and you are companion to each other.
But we're good friends. We were good friends at...
Do you share a room?
No, we each have a single room.
Oh, that's more expense for both of you, then.
The reasonable terms, you know, we're residents and they give us some special terms.
Does the owner of the hotel ever ask you to get her any liquor? Does she know what you do?
She didn't know about it. It's only today that she's found out. I dread to think what she's going to say. She might tell us to get out. We're just friends look after each other, don't we?
Bell and run like hell. I know it was a buzzer, but I still ran.
The owner of the hotel hinted that you've got a past. A criminal past?
A mistake.
What sort of mistake?
Well, I didn't actually do anything. It was simply a misunderstanding about some ingredients and a particular recipe that was operating at the time from the hotel where I was. Poulet de la creme de la mer.
And did anybody get poisoned?
There was a fair amount of illness in the Rotarians of Southport at the particular time, but most of them recovered fairly quickly.
Was there any of them that didn't recover?
It was just a genuine mistake, and some people recovered within a few weeks, and it was... Purely a coincidence.
So you got sacked?
I was asked to leave terminally, yes.
There's a question from the lady here. If the hotel was to close,
yes.
Would it be in your benefit
to be able to open your own establishment along with the owner of Majestic?
Well, my ambition, amongst others, has always been to set up a business partnership with Mrs. Forthright, and that would obviously necessitate selling the hotel and then going into a business with me. It could be a French Chez Gaspard, it could be Chez Louis Gaspard, I don't know. Chez Stella Maris, I don't know. That was her name before she was married, you know. Stella Maris.
Yeah, and how did your relationship with Forthright actually develop?
Slowly. Oh.
Why are you connected?
Ah, why? Well, at the time I was working as an assistant for the Café Royal in Blackpool in the Lobster Pot. So, and she was a second floor weekend waitress. And we dated a few times, Twisted Wheel, Island Room, Savoy Ball, you know, the sort of thing. I thought there was a future in it, but she didn't, and our ways went differently. But I still remember those days. I still remember sitting in the Twisted Wheel with a bottle of Coke and a bent straw. I do. And on the back of my scooter, yeah. Those were the days. Well, not now.
Anything else for Gavin?
Well, when the fire alarm went off, Gavin, didn't you go back into the kitchen?
No, I ran like hell outside.
But I thought you ran the other way.
No, I went as a rocket through the back door into the surrounding grounds.
And who would be financing this new operation if you and Mrs. Forthright got together?
Well, all business partnerships have either equal or unequal shares, and I think that if she sold the hotel, that would make her probably the main shareholder in the business, but I'd put my little bit in as well.
How little is your little bit?
Well, under the circumstances, I think that it's probably a little bit premature to bring in to account the money part of it, other than to say that it would probably be 70-30.
There's a question on the front row there.
When the fire alarm went off, why are you carrying your funeral ladle?
This is my little ladle. And it was presented to me some time ago by the owners of Lidl for services to the Consomme Directorate of Lidl.
Yeah, but why are you carrying it around when the fire alarm's gone off? Why can you leave
it? It's special. It's like a little pet. It follows me everywhere and I look after it. It's my main companion.
There's a question.
Did you feel jealousy when the murder victim was chatting up Stella?
She has a way, Stella, with the male customers. She is very professional in the way she handles them. And it can sometimes be misunderstood for being a little bit over-friendly. You never know, and I never know, but I keep my eye open. And there's always possibilities, but that won't get into a sticky end.
So did you get very angry when he demanded early dinner?
Not really, because the microwave was set to full, so, you know, I had no problem with that.
So was everybody being made to have the early dinner with him?
Well, they could do, you know. I mean, it's a 4 minute on full power, 2 minutes out, 1 minute in, 6 or 7 minutes, then carrying time. You know, it's not a problem, you know. Not in the Stella's kitchen, it's not, no.
That sounds as if that was the final question.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. Thank you. Oh, that's a great deal for being about. lot of revelations came out there and there. Now, ladies and gentlemen, time for break. In a moment, I'll ask you to be going out that way into the little room at the back, where you will find drinks, nibbles, answer sheets, and pens or pencils. And while you're having your drinks and nibbles, if you would like to jot down the ideas that you have, I'll be popping in to and fro to pick them up. I'll cart them away, we'll have a quick look at them, and then when you finish the drinks and we finish having a look, we'll come back here and complete the evening. Okay? Thank you very much, gentlemen. I'd like to welcome back our actors. I think Mr. Turnbull, as an ex-person, I think you have to stand.
All right.
unless you want to be.
No, I'm fine. Thank you.
Oh, no, no. Stay with us.
Jesus.
Just passing through. Right, thank you very much for your input, ladies and gentlemen. It was very interesting going through these. Each time we do one of these at a different venue, the response is always very different. And we've performed this one sort of Thornton. Your questions were very different in the main, and the responses you've written down are also very different. First of all, many of you were nearly right. I think what I mean by that will become more apparent when I get to the final announcement. Just along the way, there are a couple that I would like to read out, because there's obviously a lot of hard work and thought gone into these, and unfortunately the person who has been nominated as being responsible in each of these two cases is completely and utterly wrong. but this first one is from the St Andrews Lasses. Would you like to indicate yourselves? Who said it was the lady who owns the hotel, Stanford, right? It began as she's sly looking. She has the most to lose financially. Maybe she was intimidated by his personality because it was very overbearing and unpleasant. She likes being the boss and the prestige she has as boss. These are all the things that were true or probably true of Stella. Unfortunately, she didn't kill him.
Oh, what a shame.
The second one I'd like to just draw to your attention. This was Georgia and Sue, Jill and Joan, also known as the Thursday Book Club, and they nominated Gavin. Motive: jealousy. If the hotel closes down, he would be able to join forces with Stella to open his restaurant. He was the first to hear the fire alarm, good excuse to get everyone out. Murder victim, last to go out, used his little ladle to bash him over the head. The murder victim was giving Stella a hard time, and Stella said that Gaspar was impulsive. And all very accurate about Gaspar's personality and possible motives, but again, wrong. However, before I read the final one, which we feel is the most accurate, I think it's probably confessional time first. So, I would like to ask whoever is responsible for the murder of the people to please stand up. Can I help you?
Oh, yeah! Oh. Nearly.
Oh, no.
Nearly.
Oh, no. It was me.
Oh, no.
I admit it.
I did it. No, you mustn't say that, Minnie. You mustn't say that.
I killed him. I crept out into reception and hid there until everyone got out into the car park. And then I crept up behind him, got out my bottle of pasties and hit him on the head.
I wish you wouldn't say that, Millie. We cooked up the plan between us. It was a joint thing. I'm as much to blame as Minnie is. And, I mean, I could have done it, but I'm not very steady on my legs.
You see, we did think he was the hotel inspector. And, well, we would have been without a home, wouldn't we? I mean, we'd lived here for so long. We would have been homeless.
And if he'd got wind of our little alcohol trade, we would have been in very serious trouble.
So one way or another, he had to be taken out of the equation.
Well, he was a horrible man anyway. Not a decent person at all, and the world is better off without.
I'd just like to say one final thing. I know it's wrong to kill someone. I was taught that at Sunday school. But actually, I quite enjoy it.
Now, we come down to the rather tricky thing as to how precise we've had to be in looking at what you wrote. Because although a number of people said it was Lady Eubank and mentioned only Lady Eubank, a couple of people said that Lady Eubank was the killer and mentioned Minnie in passing. One person wrote about both of them, but had both of them to blame for everything. The only one that actually was spot on was one that said, who is responsible for the murder? Lady Eubank's companion, and she was the one who dealt the blow. It was carried out on behalf of her friend, as she is the fitter of the two, a reference there to the bad leg, and because they thought the victim was the hotel inspector, a very horrible man. They did not want to lose their home or their profitable sideline. Now that is very straightforward and comparatively brief, but is 100% accurate, and names Lady Eubank's companion. There was another one that was very close, mentioned the lady shoplifters, but did not pin it down that it was Minnie who actually hit him with something in those circumstances. And all the others it pinned it directly on Thomas, when in fact it was Minnie that did the murder.
Very good.
Okay, so the person who got it all right is Irene Evans.
Well,
would you like to... that actually nailed it. So if you would like to have a word with Liz here, who is sitting there with a piece of paper on her knee, you'll get the two tickets for our sandwich in October at the Little Theatre. And thank you for everybody with so many accurate ideas, but there were a number that had all the right ideas, but the one that doesn't.
Thank you very much for all this effort you've put into tonight.
We've had a wonderful time watching it, and it was really, really good.
It's been brilliant.
It's been really good. So we've just got a little something. I know it was only a little something.
Oh, thank you. Rehearsal.
Oh yes, thank you. But we really do appreciate it.
Thank you.
That's really said.
You just need the character now.